what does it mean to be queer? The word itself has so many different interpretations, a reclamation of one's own identity, a label, an identifier, a blanket term, an embodiment of joy, and a slur. However, no matter your own personal definition, people from the LGBTQ will always say one thing. It's a community. A place for people of any race, sex, gender, or class to come together and celebrate being themselves, no matter the restrictions placed on them or the discrimination they face in their public lives. People will always be themselves, and there will always be spaces that allow for that. TV and film is no exception. Throughout the many years of screen existing, there has always been queer media. From the Rocky Horror Picture Show and the Heartstoppers to the Wings and the Spoils. Queer media has always existed. When people think of queer media, they'll point straight to some of the biggest glorifications and stereotypes despite representation going up. Hollywood has been trying to take steps forward despite seemingly taking a couple steps in the other direction.
Haven't you ever had a girl back home that you used to hold close in your arms and kiss sometimes?
Back in the 20s, film had been predominantly silent, with the technology of the time not allowing for sound to be captured. It is at this time we have one of the first recorded uses of a homosexual kiss on screen. The silent film Wings, directed by William Wellman, depicting two men fighting for the affection of one woman, showcases their feelings for each other with a kiss. This film would go on to win the Academy Award for Best Picture, despite the queer coding throughout the movie. However, this would soon become one of a kind.
You know that Myrna had her way, she'd have had Florette pushed right out of this show.
Introducing the Hays Code. This would be a written set of rules made by Will Hays, used to enforce and censor films that entered Hollywood and the US as a whole. The public was made to believe that this was a good thing, with it being self-enforced by Hollywood. However, behind closed doors, Hollywood officials would use it to hide anything they deemed to be immoral or sacrilegious. This didn't just extend to gay and lesbian relationships. Cross-dressing, weakness in males, and even overly intellectual male characters were enough to get censored. Once the Catholic Church started pressuring Hays and his business, these restrictions and censors got even tougher. Filmmakers started using the sissy archetype to emasculate the homosexual men that they were portraying. They were seen as feminine and as such, lesser. This is similar to how they would portray women and people of color in films of the time. Harry Thomas stated in his book Sissy that under this older classification regime, men could have sex with men and remain obscenely normal in the eyes of wider society as long as they conform to masculine codes of dress, styling, and body comportment. This being reinforced through the representation of weaker men being seen as fairies, sissies, and thus not normal. The rules of the time, however, would slowly begin to be undone by pushback from foreign filmmakers as well as the US Supreme Court, finally leaving room for queer representation in the industry. Queer was out, and it was ready to be seen by everyone. The Rocky Horror Picture Show, arguably the most influential piece of queer-coded media of the last century. Set in an abandoned mansion in the middle of nowhere America, Rocky Horror is queer-coded like none other. The main antagonist of the movie, Dr. Frankenfurter, is the very essence of androgyny, literally describing himself as a...
I'm just a sweet transvestite from transsexual Transylvania.
On a mission to make his perfect man, tempting the main couple and swaying them to join him in the pleasure. Rocky Horror blew up as it hit the screens of midnight theaters across the US. However, this was hardly the only piece of queer media made in this era. Ruby Rich claims that new queer media fills these pages. It was for a kind of filmmaking characterized by a melding of style and subject in its moment of origin. And this would start to show up in works like Todd Haynes' Poison and Jenny Livingston's Paris is Burning. These directors and these films were bringing queerness to the screen in a time where being queer was not as widely accepted. Where does queer media lie today? Queer media is on the rise, with movies like Love, Simon and Moonlight gaining popularity, as well as the massively successful Netflix series Heartstopper, beloved for casting an all-queer cast in an openly LGBTQIA+ story. However, there weren't always good things that came with this rise in representation. Despite the 2022 film They/Them focusing on a very real problem, that being the forced indoctrination of queer youth in conversion camps, the movie's direction was not amazing, and it shows. The movie's delivery of these topics tended to fall flat and seemed to scream of corporate heads trying to write a movie about queerness without any thought. Without directors and writers alike bringing queer stories to a wider audience, we wouldn't be where we are today. However, we still have a ways to go. Hollywood is still casting cis white actors to play queer roles, and the public still isn't open to the problem and issues this presents. Queer media has come a long way since its first appearance in Wings, and here's to hoping that our representation becomes ever more in the future of queer media.